Ken, you're awesome. I've implemented some of the things you've mentioned, and every time they work. Thank you. One question. We have a 10-week-old American bully. How do we introduce them to our four cats?
Okay, cool. Just on that note, I only give out advice that works. That's it. I would never give advice out that doesn't work, and I would never give advice out that I've never tried at least 100, if not 1,000 times. If I don't know something, I'll be like, I have no fucking idea. I have no, my ego is big, but it is not that big. I'm not a know-it-all. I'm a simple man, simple pet dog trainer. I'm just stopping unwanted behaviors and training wanted stuff. I don't do competition. I don't do sport. So, but I only give advice on stuff that works. 10-week-old dog, ideally, it walks up to a cat and the cat smacks it in the face. That would be the best situation possible. What I would do is four cats, all depends on their personality. What are they like? I mean, you got four little freaking attitudes walking around and one 10-week-old puppy, man, you're going to be at the vet. So
four attitudes.
I would just see how it goes. See how it goes. Just don't let the, just, I don't want the dog to think it can start chasing these cats. Next. Turn the volume down because we're live. Hey, everybody. How are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. How's everybody doing? How does that look? That was pretty good. I thought you turned your volume down.
I tried. Yeah. it didn't work.
All right. How's everybody doing? Guys, all these folks are contacting me and they're like, where have you been? Is something wrong? Yada, yada, yada. And I'm like, guys, aren't you on Instagram? Like Instagram stories. If you're not on my Instagram, go to my website, solidcaninetraining.com, and there's an Instagram link. Join the Instagram because on my Instagram stories, I'm doing like 15 to 20 different cells, like little things a day. I share my whole life with you. Like you'll know what I eat, where I am. Put it this way. Whenever Linda, who's my wife, wants to know where I am, she goes on Instagram stories. That's how detailed it is. I mean, I've often thought about doing it from the bathroom, but I don't need to lose any more viewers that I'm already losing with my big mouth. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. This is the What Would Jeff Do show. I've been doing this for quite a while. I think this is show number, what, 5-something, 20-something? Anyway, 517, 521, I don't know. But anyway, I've got a training facility up in Providence, Rhode Island. I personally travel North America, actually the world, but 2019, just North America. We got about 25 seminars scheduled. Most of those seminars are for problem solving, stopping unwanted behaviors. Obviously, we train on basic obedience, but our big thing is we work with dogs that are high level human and dog aggression, lots of anxiety, lots of reactivity, so many different unwanted behaviors, things that get dogs rehomed. This is Joelle. She's one of my trainers there. She also travels with me. She documents the journey. And then she helps out, obviously, on the road as well. So that's how you find out where I am. So I was in California leading a 7-day workshop with Sean O'Shea and Tori Smith. And it's a business building, social media dog training seminar. And then you'll know. And I won't even tell you where I'm going to be Thursday because I talk about it on Instagram stories. What you can do is you ask your questions there. We will answer them. We usually don't get through all the questions. We try. Sometimes we do. It's a 90-minute show. There's something called Top Chat, Super Chat. It's a dollar sign. The dollar sign, what the dollar sign does is that you get to throw some cash our way. But your question also goes up to the top. For some reason, YouTube does it for $4.99 and up. Why? I don't know. We'll eventually see that you did a Top Chat, but it doesn't cue it up to the top. So a lot of people do that. A lot of people just do it just like, hey, thanks a lot for the free advice, the 5,000 videos. That money gets used for date night. It doesn't go to save any birds, animals, lizards. It doesn't go to save the environment. We're not trying to fucking cut down on global warming. It literally buys food for my wife and I and goes in my belly. And, ooh, I didn't even, you know what? I didn't put up any pictures from date night tonight.
Nope.
You know why? The food was good, but it was nothing, I guess, special.
Nothing Instagram.
No, right? It really wasn't. We went to Los Andes. Oh. Went to Los Andes. I just had a meal bar today. That's it, all day long. So I got pork shoulder, pork something tonight.
Their servings are enough for like 3 days.
Yeah, so. but I left have leftovers. Anyway, Joelle, let's jump right into it. Here we go.
All right, Kaylee Day. Hey, guys. Glad to see the Q&A notification again.
No shit.
T3 looked like a good turnout. Just booked the hotel room for April seminar. Can't wait.
Awesome, Kaylee J. Kaylee J. April, where are you going to be in April?
I know. What is April?
April. Which one is that, Kaylee J? That's the Jeff Gellman seminars. Next.
Multi-Kai-Kai. Aw, hell yeah. Pennsylvania here. Who else is here?
Multi-Kai-Kai. Don't do this fucking shout out. Who else? Anybody else from the PA in the house? just don't. It's not the kind of place. Like, jump on a match.com. Jump on a Tinder. Not only will you find out where people are going, you'll find out where they're coming. Next.
Wow. Amy. Hi, Jeff. We inherited my father-in-law's 90-pound pit. Added her to my house with three much smaller female dogs.
Do like cash wasn't an option? like cash?
Like, I could like see you like getting ready to like say something.
No, I'm just like, it's like.
You were building it up.
Inherited the 90-pound pit. I'm like, what's wrong with like a trust fund? Like, how about money? You know, it's like, if you're going to die, don't leave me your dog.
That's so shitty. Next. I'm not done. I didn't even finish the first question.
Oh, sorry.
Add her to my house with three much smaller female dogs. She whines all the time unless you are next to her. What do you suggest to stop the whining? Okay.
First of all, the pit doesn't miss your father-in-law at all. Okay. It doesn't. Right? Chances are the dog was always at your father-in-law's side. That doesn't mean it misses it. What it means is it's probably just not used to the situation that it's in. Whining is annoying. It's the mind racing. You can actually correct it. Don't feel bad. No, it saw its father-in-law. I don't even know if the father-in-law is dead. For all we know, he just was tired of the damn dog and he got rid of it. Or he just moved or he went to jail. You know, who knows what happened. What can you do to stop the whining? Anything you do with any other dog to stop the whining. Proper application of punishment. We talk about punishment a lot. Guys, if you're not familiar with the word punishment, it's not abuse. You're not mad. You're not angry. You're not upset. It's just a matter of fact. We reward dogs to get more of what we want, and we apply a punisher to get what we don't want. And for all the folks out there that are brand new to my show, and that like they take these one-minute clips, you've seen them, you know, these little one-minute clips. Man, why are you so angry? I'm like,
I've seen them. I make them.
I don't think I've ever, I shouldn't say that. I probably have like, I rant, but like, I'm not angry.
No.
Like, I don't know if you, like you spend 24/7 with me sometimes traveling. Yeah. Like I'm not angry.
I've never seen.
Yeah. Angry. Like, I just don't get angry. No. It's like, what, you know, life is fucking awesome. Next.
Lindsay. Hi, Jeff. Thanks again for the awesome week at T3.
Oh, Lindsay. Thank you.
My first one-on-one with three dog household went well today. Great challenges ahead. All ears for this live show. You rock.
Lindsay, proud of you. You're killing it. Remember, we talked about this at T3, right? They need to run their place like a board and train. Three crates, three food bowls, rules, structure. You got this. Kick some ass.
T3. Sandra, howdy from Texas. Let's go.
All right, Texas.
Top chat, David Smith. Oh my God. Where have you been?
The only man in America for $4.99. I mean, I bet you Kraft didn't spend $4.99 to get any attention, right? So been MIA. So have we. So
we miss you, David.
So we miss you. Working, actually training. Really? Been using 180. I hope so, because we've been talking about 180s for 5 months now. Not 360, LOL. Glad to catch you. You're never angry, even at me. Love you guys. God, no.
Not the 360. Dude. You don't want to see the 360.
Who's that guy walking around in circles all day? Oh, that's one of Jeff's listeners.
David Smith.
That's David. David, that's great. Change is falling out of his pocket. David, hold on, David. They pick up the change from the crowd. Here's $4.99. Thank you.
We're 2 minutes in. I'm already crying. I can't. All right. Melissa, good evening and welcome back, Jeff. And hello, Joelle. Hey, Melissa. Whew, Abigail. Just here to say I fucking love y'all. Thank you for donating your valuable time to us. It is life-changing for so many, including myself.
Abigail, you know, this is probably going to sound corny. It just came to my mind. Like, I have nothing. This show is never planned, by the way. I have no idea what's going to come out of my mouth at all, ever. You know, I don't look at this as donating my time. Like, I look at this as investing in humanity. I really, really do. I mean, I think I really truly feel that the time that I spend giving away massive amounts of free information is just a huge investment in humanity. I really do. I don't know if I've ever actually said that out loud. But I look at this as just like, this is all part of our job. This is our job as human beings on this planet to do like massive amounts of stuff for free with no obligation of anything back. That's what, just what we're supposed to be doing. Like, that's what we're supposed to be doing. So my pleasure. Thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate it.
Molly.
Hey, Molly.
One of two.
I want your farm.
Next. Two-part question.
All right, Molly. I'll give you a free pass. I think Molly's been a client of mine for 10 years.
Damn.
Maybe 12 years. Yep.
1 month ago, e-collar conditioned dog began territory aggression to other farm dogs after some changes. Time away from the farm, sleeping inside, death of other dogs.
Yep.
For 2 weeks, she's in command 100% of the day, duration place and down, muzzle training, structured walks, all food via training.
Yep.
With structure, there's no aggression opportunities. When do I stage situations for her to make mistakes?
So Molly, you're ready now. This is the thing. You said, this is really great. So what changed? What changed? Believe it or not, like, I'm a big fan of outside dogs. And if you knew Molly's setup on her farm, it's like, it's no big deal. But this is what the big change is. Other dogs died on the property. Got it? So whether you believe in pack mentality or not, or if you believe in the hierarchy of animals, the dogs that died were most likely higher ranking animals, right? They die. This dog now steps up and you're seeing the bad behavior. Got it? We see that all the time in multi-dog households where a dog is stepping up. That's why I'm a big advocate of like, humans, you're the leader. You run shit. So what you need to do is now you need to make sure that you really, really step it up. I would set that dog up for failure and let it know. So a lot of people struggle with that. They're like, oh, set the dogs up for success. No shit. That's easy. Set up for failure and let it know. Bad choice. Don't do that again. Next.
Top chat,
$4.99. Janet. Hey, Janet. I think you're new. Now have our dog walking on the treadmill. Yes. 2 to 3 treadmill videos, how to train your dog on a treadmill on my YouTube channel. Followed your video and it happened exactly as you described. Showed over a week now and he's walking 30 minutes a day. Thanks. Janet, bam.
Nice.
So proud of you. We demonstrate that at all the seminars too. Go to jeffgellmanseminars.com. Providence is coming up. Frederick's coming up. Wisconsin's coming up.
I think Jersey.
I'm negotiating still. I'm still negotiating. No announcement on Alaska yet. Tucson. So the latest on the radar is Tucson. That might happen.
This year?
Yeah. I'm trying to do something. Are you available? I guess I should ask you. Are you available in December?
Yeah.
November/December? We got to figure out where logistically. Nice. Yeah. So Tucson might happen
cool. This
year. Yes. Next.
Oh. As long as you don't book Alaska, I'm gone.
Can't promise. Denali National Park. Andrew. Hey, guys. Have a dog that has bad dog reactivity. Have been working hard on obedience. And I'm wondering when I can start putting him a group of dogs with muzzle like I've seen you do. Okay. Andrew, this is the thing. That won't help reactivity. The reactivity is, it's different. Okay. If it's on-leash reactivity, that's one thing. Off-leash reactivity is another. There's a special skill set of what you see us doing. When you see us working with a dog and around other dogs, there's a special skill set. What you probably don't see is step one. Got it? You see step two. We can't show step one. Why? Because of all the fucking snowflakes out there freaking out that you would correct a dog for like trying to kill another dog, God forbid. So, but step one is dog's muzzled up. It goes outside. You advocate for it by keeping other safe dogs. By the way, these have got to be safe dogs. We have a very balanced pack of dogs that we use for this specific protocol. Safe dogs away from it. If this dog acts aggressively, high level punisher. There should be no food protocols in this at all. Everyone's like, oh, that's what you use food. Like, no food with dog reactivity issues. High level punisher. Why? It needs to know that going after another dog or even take a couple steps back, thinking about going after another dog is a big mistake. Then you're going to get all these people out there, all these armchair dog trainers, all these dog trainers out there that are even like possibly even colleagues of mine. And they're like, no, that'll get the dog to associate discomfort with other dogs. They'll be more reactive. Really? No, because I showed up to the scene of the crime. Got it? We get hired after a dog has already done something that we don't like. Dangerous, unwanted behavior. We've never created an unwanted behavior. All we do is stop them. So the dog was dog aggressive, dog reactive before we showed up. Therefore, the advice that we give is impossible. I mean, I shouldn't say impossible, is not connected to the dog's doing the bad behavior. It's already doing it. Does that make sense? Next.
Moot Worm. You guys are amazing. Thanks so much for all you do. I'm excited to catch a live show.
Yeah, awesome. I'm excited to do these fucking live. Can you do one tomorrow night?
Sure.
8 p.m. tomorrow night, Eastern Standard Time. We're doing another show. Why? I'm traveling again this week. And I'm taking Romy with me. I'm taking Romy with me. She'll have fun. Next.
And I'll have the dogs. Heather. Hey, Jeff. What is the best way to build?
Yes, you will, won't you? And you get to,
I don't mind.
You get to spoon, you get to spoon with a Malinois. All,
yeah, I'm
going to
have a sleep in bed with me. I'll fucking ruin him while you're gone. Okay. Top chat, $4.99.
Top chat, $4.99. Holding on, dog. Oh, Ashley, we love you. Never have I loved a towel so much. Careful, Ashley. Yeah. All right. So much new dog in, needed to muzzle fast. Nothing worked. Got bonked on. All equipment on safely. Saved my ass. Damn right it did. Yeah. We just got that one dog in. What's that dog's name that wants to? That's
Jack. Bit,
Jack's bitten 10 people. I'm actually going to do a step-by-step rehab program for everybody out there on how we rehab that dog. Everything from getting rid of the arousal, step one, to what tools we use, the philosophy we use, the training protocols we use. And it's not about teaching obedience. It's about, like, and a lot of it's going to be like, holy shit, talking about self-preservation. I'm going to do a video on self-preservation. Self-preservation, by the way, I demonstrate this at all my seminars, because at my seminars, there's 15 to 20 dogs that are there. Many of them want to come up after me. Like, they try to bite me. So there's a move you do, which you pull the leash out like this to keep yourself safe. People need to learn how to do that, because if you don't do that, you get bit. So I'm gonna make a video on that.
Another top chat.
Another top chat, $5. I'm taking an air here. Read that.
God.
Read that.
All right. Andrew, could you suggest something for the Punisher besides an e-collar? Can't use them due to local laws. Could I keep him on leash with a prong?
You can keep him on. First of all, fuck the local laws. If you want to, I'm not telling you to break any law. All I know is I do consults with people in many countries where shock collars are against the law. All right. So, and they're still using them, but out of respect for your local laws, and I want to see you get arrested, because don't call me for fucking bail. A bonker is great. A bonker is a cotton towel. This actually can be more powerful than a shock collar. You just can't get distance and it doesn't go through walls. So, but I've got a video on how to make it and how to use it. And leash and prong is always good. Heel taps can be good. All depends on what you're trying to stop. But man, all I'm telling you is remote cowers are fantastic. And no, they're not. That's why countries are banning them. You know that women can't drive in certain countries, right? Like, you realize that, correct? Like, they can't vote. They can't drive. Just because a country is mandating something, that doesn't mean it's right. What happened was a bunch of really loud snowflakes are pushing an agenda who've got a huge money machine behind them, and the acronym is PETA. All right, next.
Another top chat,
$5. Joel, my dog Zeta is very reclusive and runs away from me. Pitbull mix we got from shelter 3 months ago. Okay, so this is the thing. So Joel, have you ever trained recall? Meaning, have you ever trained the dog to come back on command where it comes back on command 99.9% of the time? Most likely not, and that doesn't make you unique. It makes you normal. Keep a leash on this dog at all times. Lots of structure. Cut down on affection. People think, if you give enough affection, the dog will want to be with you. If it was that easy, that's all we would do. A lot of rules, a lot of structure. No free roaming right now. Watch my videos on the place, on the walk, my philosophy on how a dog in a household should be. Teach recall training. You know, a remote collar is going to be your best friend. There's so many things you can do, but it's massively proactive. Next.
Another top chat.
Are you sure? Mm-hmm. Matt, hey, Malamute has food aggression. E-collar 90 to 100 makes her flinch, but not back away. Not surprised. Using prong collar, she turns around and tries to bite his suggestions. Okay. So she turns around and we have to do a freaking food resource guarding video too. Okay. A really good one, like the one that's going to give me a lot of hate. Not that I want to get a lot of hate, but that's how like in depth and real and true it's going to be, because dogs are being killed. Mm-hmm. I really don't give a shit if people don't like it or not. People need to see how to stop food aggression.
We don't have any resource guarders right now. Well, Lexi was with the ball, but
I saw that. So what I want you to do is, because of the breed of the dog, and it's because it's a fur conversation. It's a fur conversation, not a dog conversation. Okay, cool. If Jack will probably be resource guard something.
Yeah.
Something. What I want you to do is I want you to get the thick fur contact points. I want you to move up probably to a boss. And I want to make sure you shave down a little area on both sides, not down to skin. You'll get good contact. Then I want you to try it. The reason why the dog is redirecting on the leash is not because prong collars make dogs aggressive, because it's an objection. The dog is saying no, the leash is attached to the collar, the leash is keeping the dog from moving where it wants to go, and if I bite the leash, guess what? I eventually can get away from you. It's a classic redirection. Dogs do it all the time. And your dog would do it on a slip lead as well, or a martingale collar, or any other gentle collar that somebody else approved of. Next.
Geez, I don't know. I lost my place. There are too many. Heather. Hey, Jeff, what is the best way to build engagement with a dog, especially on walks when they are easily distracted by other people and dogs? Thanks. Love all your content.
So Heather, you're not trying to get engagement with a dog on the walk. You're just trying to get your dog to stop looking at nonsense. Now, if you build engagement, it won't do that. I get that. But we don't do focused healing. We're pet dog trainers. What you need to do is teach the dog how to just break off from staring at something else. Remote collar is good for that. A 180 move is good for that. A gentle heel tap on the hindquarters is good for that. But getting a dog to look at you with a classic watch me is going to be really, really hard to do unless the dog has an intense, a working line focus protocol put in, which we don't do. Next.
Josue, hello. T3 looked awesome.
It was awesome. Next. Except for my sleeping accommodations.
Bobby.
But I love going to the gym at 4 a.m. Next.
Bobby. Dog sometimes isn't whining on place exactly, but is making a soft noise, almost like strained breathing. It's like one step down from whining, correct? As if it is, we're whining?
No, just turn the music up. Next.
Zach. Hello, Jeff. I just got a 2-year-old Akbash.
Whoa.
Brought her home about 15 minutes ago. She snarls at my small pug when he gets in her face. Should I bonk her? And how early can I start doing corrections?
No, Zach, buddy, take a step back, right? Take a step back. If I brought a brand new dog home 15 minutes ago, it wouldn't meet any of my dogs for days. Days. Okay? That doesn't mean you didn't make a mistake. You didn't know. It's like, hey, my dog just bit my pug's face off. What did I do wrong? It's like, whatever. It's like, no. So what I want you to do is massive amounts of structure, lots and lots of structure. All right. Give that dog it needs to get a little bit of recovery time, but structure. So structure isn't meaning kennel up. The dog should be in the kennel a lot right now. Now, and we don't use kennels as bad dog go in the kennel. It's just I can't just leave you out. I don't know what you're going to do. Kennel up. Next.
Joe, hey guys, good to see you again.
Joe, it's great to be seen. Great to be back.
Red Riding Hood and the Wolf. Would a working line German Shepherd be a good choice for a multi-purpose service dog?
It's probably not my first choice. Maybe a region, which means maybe because it didn't have drive. You know what I mean? It didn't have enough drive. So all depends on the skill set of the trainer. All depends on what the tasks you are needed, you needed to do. All depends on the skill set then of the handler as well. A lot of variables there. Next.
Mike, welcome back, guys. Counting down to Providence.
Mike, see you there.
Shane, hey, training an Aussie Doodle. I have my German Shepherd completely off-leash trained using an e-collar, so I'm very familiar with a good system. My question is, I can't seem to get him food motivated. He hasn't eaten in 3 days and still doesn't seem interested. Any ideas?
Yeah. Well, a dog, make sure the dog's got water, number one. The dog is large enough to go at least a week without food. Whenever I talk about that is like, guys, we're not withholding food from the dog. It's there. They're just not taking it. What you can start to do is, and someone said, use higher value food. It's like, yeah, just eat hot dogs and the dog will have an explosive diarrhea like every night. Just give it liver treats, pepperoni. Your dog will be shitting everywhere. No, it needs to actually eat, you know, eat food. Guys, watch out for your dried kibble. Let's all do this, guys. Let's all educate ourselves on. Let's all educate ourselves on this, on DCM, dilated cardiomyopathy. Dilated cardiomyopathy, DCM. Everybody write that down. It's related to grain-free foods, which we have recommended.
That's what Matilda has. Yes. That Dana been training.
Yes, yes. Okay. Read up on that, guys. Read up on that.
Yeah,
all right.
Pretty crazy.
A lot of what's it called? Recalls of food right now.
Yeah.
All right. So the answer to the question is I'd go a couple more days, always give it, use food for the training. Sometimes you can put it on the ground instead of out of your hand and stick to it. Stick to it. Next.
Top chat.
Top chat, $5. Matt, to clarify, Malyumu tries to viciously bite my hand's body while using prong collar outside of food aggression training. She's very, okay. This is what I would do. That's what your dog is doing. It's not the prong. I just want to make sure that we also clarify it's not the prong collar. Because we have dogs that do that with flat buck collars on. It's still an objection. It's so important that we don't connect prong collars with aggression. Because every dog that comes into me for aggression is not on a prong collar or a shock collar. It's just the dog saying no. I've been mauled before by a dog on a flat buckle collar. It didn't want to get into my truck. It said no and like put me in the hospital. You muzzle up the dog and you make it suck to behave that way. We have a very strict protocol on how we deal with that. There's a skill set to that though. It's not something I can just casually tell you over here. So I would, if that dog is going after you, you muzzle it up. You muzzle it up. Next.
Garrett, Jeff, used to drink beer while I watched your show. Now I ride my spin bike. You are so motivating. Get some.
Nice. Nice. That was Garrett, right? Garrett, proud of you. Proud of you. Nice. And just to let you know, I used to be a triathlete. So I did cross country, then I did triathlons. So I've grown up being active. But at 53, I probably had a good 10-year spout of like not doing the best things. So I recently lost 25 pounds. I'm getting into good shape, and it's all because of this lady.
Yours truly.
Oh, by the way, the topless challenge. If anyone's familiar with the topless challenge that was going on in supposed to happen when I went out to California between myself and Sean O'Shea. I was ready for it. Somebody else backed out. Somebody backed out. The guy that's been working out hard for years, like backed out of the guy that's been working out hard for 4 to 5 months. Just saying.
Top chat.
Top chat. Andrew, thanks for the advice. It's fear aggression with other dogs, even though he's evenly tempered with people. Still, say, whether it's fear aggression or not, advocate for the dog. Same protocols apply. Next.
Melissa posted the link to our Instagram page.
Awesome. Thank you.
Chris, how concerned should I be about using a pet convincer to correct one dog in a multi-dog situation? One dog whining in a crate or one dog needing correction on walk or even use against off-leash dog?
You definitely get the shrapnel effect of a pet convincer. If you're not familiar with a pet convincer, it's compressed air. And if you've got two or three dogs around, they all might think that like something else, they did something wrong. So it's a concern. Next.
JT. Hey, Juan, here from California. Is there a certain order to train a 5-month-old GSD? down first before long stays, crate training, etc. Also love the show. Greatest content on YouTube.
Thanks. I'm just trying to get caught up here. I'm so behind. Small Engine Luke is the latest one I have. I got stuck on a Top Cat. What I want you to do is down. I would do 3, 4, 5, 6 second weekend. So 3, 4, 5 days or second weekend. No rush to down. Crate training is number one. Dog's got to go into a crate, right? So I would do crate training one, place number two, leadership skills and thresholds as well. Don't rush the down. Don't rush the down. Next.
Small Engine Luca. I'm moving in with some friends for the next 2 months. Any tips to help preserve my dog's good behavior, prevent regression with the new location?
Yeah, massive amounts of structure. Hold the dog accountable. I'm not a big fan of dogs in bedrooms, but since you're moving with friends, dogs, your crate in the bedroom, put your dog in there. Next.
Ken, you're awesome. I've implemented some of the things you've mentioned and every time they work. Thank you. One question. We have a 10-week-old American bully. How do we introduce them to our 4 cats?
Okay, cool. Just on that note, I only give out advice that works. That's it. I would never give advice out that doesn't work. And I would never give advice out that I've never tried at least 100, if not 1,000 times. If I don't know something, I'll be like, I have no fucking idea. I have no, my ego is big, but it is not that big. I'm not a know-it-all. I'm a simple man, simple pet dog trainer. I'm just stopping unwanted behaviors and training wanted stuff. I don't do competition. I don't do sport. So, but I only give advice on stuff that works. 10-week-old dog, ideally it walks up to a cat and the cat smacks it in the face. That would be the best situation possible. What I would do is 4 cats, all depends on their personality. What are they like? I mean, you got 4 little freaking attitudes walking around and 1 10-week-old puppy, man, you're going to be at the vet. So
4 attitudes.
I would just see how it goes. See how it goes. I don't want the dog to think it can start chasing these cats. Next.
Joe, my 5-month-old GSD is great when meeting new dogs. He's respectful, not aggressive, nor dominant. But when it comes to the owners or people, he's very skittish and runs off. Advice?
Yeah, well, he's going through a fear stage. We're going to be publishing up a fear. Tori Smith is writing up a good 1-year-old dog in fear stage thing that we went over at T3. So the dog.
Hey,
Angelo.
Let me guess, you saw me in the little thing.
We heard you coming in.
We heard you.
All right. Here, dying. You're going to go tonight? Good night, honey.
Good
love
night,
you.
Papa.
Good night. Love you.
Good night, Joel.
Good night, Angelo.
Love you.
Sweet dreams.
I love you too, sweetheart. Thanks.
Good night, Kira. Good night, Chuck. Good night, girl.
He's so damn cute.
He's really good. Okay. Question. people. So don't let people pet the dog. What? How's he supposed to be socialized? Him being afraid around other people is not socialization. Existence, but not interaction. Next.
Jenny, just found this podcast last week. Been binging the show ever since. Excited to catch you live for the first time.
Jenny, glad you found me. Welcome to the family. Next.
Paraz, hi, Jeff. Welcome back. Been using e-collar for regular training and discipline and working well.
Nice.
Is it okay to use sound as a preempt to the shock? He responds well to it in low distraction places.
I don't, but if it works for you, do it. Next.
Kaylee J, April seminar in Wisconsin.
Oh, that's going to be a fun one. Ooh. At Beckett Dog Training.
Cool.
We're flying to that one. Nice. I'd love to drive to that one.
That would be really far.
But it's not paired. Well, not if we were in Chicago or Elkhart, it wouldn't be that far.
Yeah.
Because we're already there.
Yeah.
But yeah. Next.
Top Chat.
Top Chat, $5. Brian, J&J, you're beautiful. You're obviously talking to her. Glad I finally caught another live. Dakota is coming along so good. Dog cat reactivity is still there. Can't break her arousal. Brian, you need to have a – okay, this is not because I'm a dog trainer. It's not because I've got a special skill set. If I went to your house, I'd break your dog's arousal around the – and we're not breaking the dog, guys. Don't go down that slippery fucking path. I would do it. And the reason is because something inside here – and I'm a very emotional person. I mean, I cry a lot, especially because I've got young kids and I've got daughters. So I'm very, very connected to my emotions. And I've got a soft spot for a lot of different things, especially humans. But when it comes to dogs, I'm more methodical. I'm more rational. And something about you is not applying a proper punisher to this dog that has meaning to it. So something's holding you back. So that's why dog trainers bring some of their dogs to me, because they don't have that. They're great with their clients, but with their own dogs, they struggle. So what I would do is, you got to figure out what it is. Bonker, remote collar, figure out what it is. Next.
Shift Uber Lyft. Any reason why my 3-year-old pit mastiff lashed out at my sister? Never has done it before and hasn't happened since. It was weird.
Could have been anything. It could have been. I wasn't there. I haven't seen the video. I need a lot more information. And that would be like a one-on-one Skype. By the way, I do Skypes, guys. I'm not saying that so you guys will give me money. But if you go to my website, sollycanontraining.com, I do Skypes. I do anywhere from 1 to 5 a day around the world, all different time zones. It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool when you start seeing people like in Israel and Russia and Rio de Janeiro. You see they're like, you know, where they, you know, their places. And it's like, oh, wow, cool. It's like I'm just right in your living room there. Yep. I don't know. I don't know what happened. Next.
JT, Juan here again. First time catching your live show. Can't wait for you to come to Northern California.
Nice. I'll be in San Francisco. Next.
It's a different town, though. Right? City?
Paluma, maybe?
Paluma?
Something like that. So I'm chopping it up. So no disrespect for your town. Yes.
Cataluma or something. Yeah. Paige. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. We're in the process of training my 6-month-old Roddy, but his bad behaviors have really rubbed off on our previously trained 6-year-old female. What to do?
Get rid of those bad behaviors ASAP, and then step up the training on the dog that has already been trained. Next.
Melissa posted the link to your seminar.
No, thanks.
Abigail, training my pit on e-collar for reactivity and making great progress.
Nice.
Soon we will have to be in a home with another dog. Suggestions for introduction and having them live together for a short period?
Yeah, existence. Don't feel like you have to introduce them. Don't feel like they have to be friends. Don't feel like they've got to be lovers. Don't feel like they've got to, like, you know, hang out on the same bed and like take the picture and put it on Instagram. It's really like, how do we make sure they don't fight? That's my only priority right now. And then you take it from there. Next.
Jackie, how would you correct fence jumping privacy when dog chasing something in backyard, working on recall, but still having trouble with squirrels, act of God correction when close to fence?
So that means you haven't done it if there's a question mark after, before that. Number one, don't use recall to stop fence jumping. Can we talk about this all the time? Don't use recall to stop fence jumping. Make fence jumping suck. Then you can always call your dog back if you want to or not. So dog rushes over to the fence with it, have a long line on the dog. It's trying to jump it 100 on the remote for 3 seconds. And I can see all the snowflakes now. Oh my gosh, that's horrific. That's mean. You've never seen a dog hit by a car. You've never seen your dog clear a fence, run into traffic, and hit by a car. And if it doesn't die, you've never had to pay the bill. You'd have no empathy for people that have had to struggle with that. And if anybody thinks that a 3-second high-level punisher, and yes, it hurts, is worse than what I just described, please don't own a dog. And please don't have kids. Because you look too small. You don't look at the big picture. You're looking at the moment. You're not looking at the big picture. But dogs die every year because they run out into traffic. Like, people are spending $3,000 on a dog that ate a sock to get it removed. $3,000. I think you can take a trip around the world for $3,000. Maybe you can't, like, stay in every city over 3 months, but you can, like, do some pretty cool stuff for $3,000. And having surgery, which lasts an hour, and the dog didn't learn anything, wouldn't be my first choice. Next.
Matt, have a 9-month-old Malamute. When I tried to discipline her on the prong collar, I think we answered that already.
Yep.
Victor, I have a question from Puerto Rico. I use prong collar 2 days. The dog bites the leash. Something wrong, or I need more time?
No. Okay, guys, it's called redirection. I have had dogs do that on slip leads, on martingale collars, on flat buckle collars, on harnesses. The dog is just objecting. That's all it is. That's all it is. And just to also let folks know, it's a choice. What I mean by that is, very often I'll have a couple come in for dog training. It could be a boy-girl couple, a boy-boy couple, or a girl-girl couple. A couple's a couple's a couple. The point is, two adult humans living in the same household with one dog. And very often, the dog will do that biting of the leash with one person, but not the other. or usually they'll do it with the owner, but not the trainer. Why? Why? It's a choice. Two classrooms of children have two different teachers. Okay? In the morning, they go to one teacher. In the afternoon, they go to another teacher. And one of the teachers goes, "My God, I got the worst class ever." Another one goes, "My gosh, I got the best class ever." Same students. So it's a choice. What do? Muzzle up the dog, work it through it. Use the bonker. The dog goes after the leash, no, and then bonk. Next.
Jordan, my six-month-old husky goes out to the bathroom in her kennel no matter how much we take her out. She lays, sits, and walks in it. Mm. Her kennel is the right size, only big enough for her.
So you got a dog that's reversed housebroken. That's not my skill set. That's not my skill set. What we would do is, the only advice I can probably give you is, you know how people make crates a little bit shorter? Make it lower. Not forever, guys, but pretty much the dog is crawling into it. Now, that's not, I don't want my dogs living like that either. This is just for a little bit. The dog can't historically stand up to go to the bathroom. So pretty much it goes into its crate and it lies down. Try that for a while. And then, but again, like full, listen to the narrative, everybody. You know, I'm not saying this to you guys, but I make all these recommendations and folks are like, "Oh my gosh, he thinks that you should just like put dogs in like pitch black." It's like, you know what I mean? It's like listen to the narrative. Next.
Jordan, my dog got banned from doggy daycare for redirecting, apparently unprovoked. What can I do to eliminate that? Honestly, I don't believe them. We've been through so much training with aggression. Muzzle?
Most dog training facilities aren't set up for dogs that do stupid stuff. So, you know, there's always a provocation. Unless the dog has a brain tumor, nothing is random, right? There's no randomness to it. So, you know, what can you do about it? Not much, because it's all on the, it's more training on your end is not going to make, yes, it could make a difference to the daycare. But what I mean by is like, that's daycare applicable. That's their skill set, how they run the dogs, how they work the dogs. Are they getting the dogs in drive? Are they getting the dogs all aroused? Aroused dogs, high drive dogs doing high drive stuff, sometimes they make stupid choices. So that would be, you know, I would say don't do doggy daycare. You know, get a dog walker instead. Next.
Mike, is it preferable to bring an open wire crate or the enclosed plastic crate for my dog when coming to the seminar?
Mike, whatever is easiest for you, buddy. Next.
Avery, my dog is aggressive. We have a prong collar on. He gets all crazy. Like today, he took a ponytail off the floor. We tried to do an exchange for a treat, and he just lashed out and tried biting off my hand.
So Avery, I would never, okay, this isn't JCPenney's. We don't do exchanges. There's no exchanges. We don't do final sales either, but there's no exchanges. Everybody stop doing the exchange thing to get the dog to drop something. That's how you train dogs to not drop stuff. That's how you train dogs to steal things. So I've got a video on the out command. Watch my video on the out command. All right. Watch that. Next.
Michelle, my dog has improved from his separation anxiety since using your strategies, but still pants and doesn't sleep in the crate. How can I get her to the next step of sleeping and fully relaxed?
What do you mean doesn't sleep in the crate? Where does the dog sleep?
No, probably not actually falling asleep.
It's up all night? I don't believe it. The dog's got to sleep at some point. You think that dog is just
maybe not at night. Maybe like when she's at work. It's very vague. You don't know. It could just be standing up pacing all day in the crate. I don't know.
Well, shit, that's when you do the shortness thing. At night, who's gonna win? You or the dog? Sometimes it's a battle of wills. Sometimes it's a battle of will. So that's what you got to do. Next.
Jack, 8-month Doxy is remote collar trained, great on leash, but shakes head a lot. Think it dislikes the prong collar. Correct or switch to slip since behaved and on e-collar. Tried to correct, but not improving.
You can go to a Martingale remote collar protocol. We don't. Check the ears for, it's a dachshund. Check its spine, number one. Also check its ears for an ear infection or its teeth for tooth issues, for dental issues. Check that. Next.
Abigail, and hi, David Smith. Love you too. Laughing my ass off.
Everybody loves David.
Oh, nice. David. Hey, dog. Hey, Jeff, is it possible to get a basset hound to stop fence digging?
Yeah. Anybody that says they can't, they suck. hang up your fucking dog training shingle. It's like, you can get any dog to stop just about any behavior, you know? Yeah, you absolutely can. How do you do it? Shock collar at the highest level for 3 seconds when the dog digs. If you make, and it might not be high enough, you might need a double collar. Bottom line is this. If you make a behavior suck, it will stop. Welcome to the animal kingdom. They absolutely will stop doing it. You know, and it's not a basset hound conversation. It's a dog digging a hole conversation, just to let you know. All right, next.
Avery, we don't know whether he is trying to be dominant or is just resource guarding. How do we correct this behavior? We can't even approach him when he's on his bed and doesn't want us there.
Okay. This is the one with the redirect, the exchange?
Yeah.
Okay. First of all, I want to know what the hell ponytails are doing on your ground.
No, like a ponytail holder.
That's not what she said.
I know. She said ponytail, but like, I'm assuming.
Like a scrunchie?
Like a scrunchie.
Oh. I'm like, what the hell is what are they doing? God. What are they doing? What's their ponytails there? You know? So what I want you to do is watch my video on the out command. Okay. And this whole thing about the beginning, trying to be dominant or just resource guarding, it doesn't matter. The dog's being an asshole. We call it being a dick. You're going to get a dog trainer to come in there and give you this is what it is. It's called this. And they're like, okay, that's really cool. But now how do I fix it? That I don't know. I don't know how to fix it. I can just identify what the problem is. So that's your bullshit fucking excuse for just sucking? No. Don't tell owners what it is if you can't figure it out how to fix it. And how would you know what it was if you didn't know how to fix it in the first place? So it's called unwanted behavior. The out command with a shock collar is going to stop it. And we stop that in about 3 to 5 seconds. All the time. I demonstrate it at all my seminars. We do it at the training center. Yes, it lasts for a long time. Yes, you can do it. It's actually one of the simple. It's easier to fix that than train a down command. Mm-hmm. Seriously, we stop resource guarding. I find resource guarding easier to train than recall, down, any trick out there, including paw. Just about like anything. Resource guarding is one of the easiest things to stop. Next.
C2 Knits. I've really missed you guys. Heart.
Oh, I missed you too. Thanks.
Laura. Hey guys, how's it going? Boss and I have been slacking a bit whilst family were visiting, but managed to get him to lay calmly under my seat in a restaurant, and he was an angel. Your advice works.
Awesome, Laura. Yeah, it's normal that people slack a little bit when whether you're on a trip or you're away or like what life goes on. Next.
Deanna, Rottweiler is fine with me on walks, but as soon as I bring him into a fenced in yard, he won't let me near him. We have a standoff as he stares and growls.
Fuck that.
Whoa.
What? Get yourself a remote collar and tell the dog, we're not going there. Literally like, no, correct. That'll make the dog more aggressive. No, it's already starting to be aggressive. So, but are you sure it's not play? And I'm being serious. Like my dogs growl when they play tug. You sure the dog isn't talking to you? And I only say that because we have actually had clients in our training center. 3 weeks ago, I can remember one. The dog is staring at me. He wants to kill me. I'm like, no, he's being engaged with you. Or, oh my gosh. The dog is barking at me. He wants to attack me. No, that's like just engagement barking. He probably wants you to throw something. Or, oh my God, the dog's about to kill something. It's like, no, that's called a play bow. So, you know, I'm not saying that's you, but you know, I mean, like there's dogs that speak, like, you know, like huskies and boxers and I don't know what that is. But all I know is that you stop it by making it suck. Next.
Gorilla, what would you do if you're walking your dog and another dog starts charging at your dog?
If I had a gun, I'd shoot it. And if I didn't have a gun, what I would do is, especially charging my dog with intent. Oh my God, that's so horrific. You've never seen a dog killed in front of you then. Like if a dog is going to be injured, it's not going to be mine. Simple concepts. You know, no, I don't go around shooting dogs. No, I'm not telling people to shoot a dog. I was being a little bit flippant with that conversation, that recommendation. But if my dog was absolutely being attacked by another dog and I couldn't stop it, of course I would. I'd like to think anybody would do whatever it took to save the life of their dog, the life of their child, the life of a loved one, the life of another human being, and also to protect themselves. I'd like to think that people would do that. It's not my fault that this dog is charging my dog. Yes, this dog pays the price, but why should my dog pay the price? So dog goes behind you and then kick the dog. That's usually the easiest thing to do. But if that doesn't work, figure it out. Figure it out. $5 top chat. Paraz, German Shepherd, now 1 year old, has very good structure in house and crating. Thinking of transitioning to sleeping out of the crate overnight. Any transition tips? I don't, because we don't do that. We don't transition dogs from crate to out of crate. So what I suggest you do is jump onto YouTube and do some research. Next.
Aaron, dog has bitten 9 year old 2 times in the last 3 years while being pet. 99% of the time the dog is calm. Okay with adults, kids, no idea what provoked her. What would Jeff do? I use bonker, prong, and e-collar. Not sure how to set her up.
I won't. Unfortunately, Aaron, I'm not going to give you advice when it comes to on this tone of a show where the content is all accurate. Everything I say is accurate. Everything I say is works. But you can tell the tone of the show is a little bit like, you know, entertainment. When it comes to children and it comes to dogs biting, I'm not going to give you advice that because it's a multi-stepped, in-depth protocol that's not just one or two things. It's everything. What I want you to do right now is no petting of that dog. That's not the answer. That's not the final answer, but it's the safest thing I can say right now. Find someone in your area that specializes in aggression rehab. Okay, true aggression rehab. They understand the concept of reward and punishment. Is that a power cord?
I think so.
Yep, we need that. So that's what I would recommend right now. All right, thank you. Next.
Thank you. Next. Michelle, Alberta, Canada government trying to end dog fighting with new legislation. Idiots fuck have included that. Banning treadmill training for dogs.
Jesus fucking Christ. Jesus we Christ. We need
to fight back on these.
Okay. This guy's, hey, Michelle, I love you, by the way. Okay, I'm not ignorant to the fact that dog fighting exists. I'm not ignorant. But guess what? It ain't that fucking big. And you don't pass laws based on 0.5% or not, or even less than that. You don't, first of all, you already have laws in place. So is dog fighting illegal? Yes or no? Yes, it's illegal. Fine. That doesn't mean you ban treadmills. What's next? Okay. Every dog that comes into my training facility learns how to walk on a treadmill. All my dogs are treadmill trained. No dog in my facility is a dog fighting dog. None of my dogs are dog fighting dogs. Every dog that comes into my seminars, I will train on it. I don't have time to do it, but I will train. They all want their dogs to walk on treadmills. None of them are fighting their dogs. Government, stay out of shit. Literally. By the way, I'm not angry. I'm just passionate. It's like, stay out of stuff. Literally, stay out of people's bedrooms. Stay out of people's doghouses. Stay out of people's lives. Unless it's a like Homeland Security, a national security risk. Okay. But other than that, stay the fuck out. Banning treadmills because of dog fighting. Guess you know what else those dogs do? They eat food. Ban food. Ooh, they wear flat buckle collars. No more flat buckle collars. They live in houses. No dog owners are allowed to own a house anymore because it's a fighting dog. And I'm being serious. It's like, what's next? Stand up and say, you get away from me. Meaning government, back off. No. Next.
Woo, Melissa, such ridiculous legislation in Alberta.
Yeah.
Randy, want to thank you for all your information. You're a life changer.
Awesome. Thank you, Randy.
Gary, Jeff, do you use dog's name every time with multiple dogs? My 6-month-old and 3-year-old Golden keep getting confused and they often both follow a single command.
Gary, I don't, because I have my dogs do all the same stuff. Literally, go outside, come back inside, go in the truck, get out of the truck, go lie down, go to place. We're going for a walk. Shut the hell up. That's it.
That's it.
That's it. Next. But you can. What I would do is do name training. So next.
Andrew, hi Jeff, Patty, and I thank you for your wisdom. My Belgian Malinois exerts boundless energy in one place, but then is up and going in about 5 seconds. Repeat, same results. Any suggestions?
Andrew, as I look at my high drive Belgian Malinois at my feet, who only got 15 minutes of exercise today.
I ran him this morning too, before you got back.
For how long?
Probably a half hour.
Who got 45 minutes of exercise today? Did you really? Oh, that's right. I was on a flight.
Yeah, I ran him.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much. But I'm not going to, no one's tiring out my dogs. So no. I've got two high drive German Shepherds and a high drive Mal. And you're not going to tire them out. So, but they learn how to do duration stuff. The magic to duration stuff is the application of a punisher for the known command. So what you need to do is when the dog knows place, this is only on commands where the dog knows the command. Then what you'll do is the dog breaks the command, no, and then correct. Now, when you see dogs at our training facility and you see them all lying down, I would say what? After week one, they should do an hour place.
After a week, they're doing like hours of place.
Okay, there you go. That doesn't mean they're not biting our faces anymore, trying to, but place is one of the easiest commands to get duration. Next.
Heather, T3 was so inspiring. I'm so happy to see y'all back on the usual Q&A.
Heather, thank you so much.
Molly. Thank you. I guess I knew. I just have to go for it, but I still need that little bit of extra reassurance. I'll let you know how it goes. Super proud to be a client for 10 years now.
I know, Molly. Thank you. Molly, I talk about you at almost every seminar. When you guys called me from, where was that, Africa, and you found a street dog.
Oh, that's her?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, I heard that story.
And you trained it with like, what, a rope, a treat bag, and a bonker, or something like that. Yeah, it's like, I tell that story all the time. It's like, what would they do before they did shock collars? I'm like, well, let me tell you about Molly. Yeah. It's like, you don't need these tools, but you're also with the dog 24/7 and you're doing it back like how your folks used to do it. Next. Yeah.
Stephanie, hey Jeff, I got another GSP and she's doing really good, except she lets me know when she needs to go number two when she's in her crate, but soaks her bed with pee. Anything I can do to help her?
Stephanie, number one, say shit, not number two. Okay. This is an adult show. I'm not the best freaking potty guy. I mean, I struggle with my own freaking bladder and bowel. So I'm not there. Sorry.
No, I travel with you every hour. God. It's true. It's so true. I'm sorry.
Joelle.
What?
Would you like me to carry a mason jar and as I'm driving, piss into it? You'll probably.
It's like every hour. But you're, like you have no.
But you. But you'd probably freaking put in a claim with something if I did that. I can't have one of my.
It's just bizarre.
It's not. Okay. First of all, it's not every hour. Okay. I'll tell you what. When's our next road trip? Frederick, Maryland.
Frederick.
Document it.
Okay.
Document it.
I will.
I also drink a ton of water to stay hydrated.
I do too.
But I'm 53. I'm getting old. Okay.
Okay.
I'm getting old. I can't hold it as much. I'm going to be the old guy that gets up every hour in my bathrobe walking around downtown Providence with my fucking slippers on, you know?
I'll document it then too.
Yeah, sure. If you know me back, if you know me then, I ain't that far off. No. 10 years from now.
I was thinking like three.
So I'm not the best guy. I'm not the best guy with the pee stuff. Next. Check for a UTI. Check for UTI. Next.
Amber, the Sparkle Fox. 11-month Great Dane pup is losing interest in treats, toys a little. How could I work on getting him more interested?
One more thing, Stephanie, get rid of the bed. Lose the bed. I don't know. I mean, I don't know. There's a bunch of videos out there by sport dog trainers to build engagement with toys. I'm not the one that, you know, because the only thing I do with my dogs is play chuck it. So that's not really my skill set either. Next.
Steph, an off-leash dog ran up to us yesterday, ignoring owner. My dog is reactive, but surprisingly no one was hurt or blew up. Still feeling a bit shaken. Any tips on how to handle in the future?
Yeah, Steph, I mentioned that before. Yeah, foot out. Boom. Kick it. Kick it. Next.
Janet, have been following you for 2 years now and hoping to do a seminar weekend with my daughter and our dog, or a Skype to start, but seminar is definitely something we want to do.
Janet, woo-hoo. You've been following me for 2 years. What do I got to do to get you to a seminar? There's snacks, complimentary lunch.
Coffee.
Joelle is there now. What do I have to do to get you a seminar?
Jokes.
Lots of jokes. I don't actually tell jokes.
No.
I got one joke.
funny remarks.
Yep. JeffGellmanSeminars.com. You tell me which seminar you want to go to, and I'll make sure it happens. Okay? Next.
Lori, I was wondering what happened to your Patreon. I think it's been 2 weeks that I haven't seen a video, and then you posted a question answer. Did I miss it?
I answered your question, Lori. Yeah, I was away. And when I'm away working 18 hours a day, and I'm literally like, I fall behind on some stuff. But yesterday I posted up the video answers and then a new Q&A. It should have gone up. I'm pretty sure it went up. All right, next.
Janet says, I posted about the treadmill earlier.
Nice.
Alex, is your facility hiring in the upcoming month?
Sure. We're always looking for good people. Nice, sure. Nice people. Number one thing, nice.
Stephanie, our one-year-old GSD is on an e-collar and it has done amazing things. How old does our two-month-old GSP have to be to go on e-collar? Completely forgot the age they have to be.
You can, at 12 or 14 weeks, you can start conditioning the dog to the e-collar. No high-level corrections. Just condition it. Lots and lots of food. Get it excited about it. Next.
Gary, I love your snowflake reference. Been using it. It gets the point across perfectly.
Yeah, a lot of fucking snowflakes out there. It's a snowstorm every day. We should all walk around with shovels.
Oh, my God.
I know.
Nancy, adopted 9-year-old Akita that was an outdoor only and had little contact with other animals except rodents he killed.
Yep.
How do I train him to not kill my cat? Left claws in his nose, not deterred by it.
Ooh.
So, Nancy, there's a lot. First of all, you have a 9-year-old outside dog. Is there any way you can keep him an outside dog? Or are you trying to domesticate him? Are you trying to get this dog to live inside? I don't know anything about this dog, but all I know is I owned an Akita. He was an outside dog. I have a German Shepherd that's an outside dog. If I had more property, all my dogs would be outside dogs. That doesn't mean I wouldn't do stuff with them. And we're not talking about on a chain, guys. Okay? We're not talking about on a chain. We're talking about, like, you know, living outside. Dog, you know, climate-controlled doghouse, access to water. Obviously, you feed them, and you still exercise them. But you're going to have to be the punisher. I'd be super concerned about a dog that lived outside and was allowed to probably kill prey coming in and you trying to get inside with a cat. So, but then again, if it hasn't killed a cat yet, it probably could. That's a good sign. I'd put the dog into avoidance. Avoidance means the last thing it ever wants to do is go even near the cat. And that's done with a remote collar / shock collar. And then there's obviously some duration work you can do inside as well. But I'd be careful about, you know, I wouldn't say be careful. I love an outside dog, number one, and I've owned it. I've got a beautiful Akita, and it's beautiful. It's beautiful to see them outside. Next.
Josue, I went to a pet expo, and I was able to walk her around like a champ. She even did an agility course they had and did amazing. Jumping over fences finally came in handy.
Good. Well, there you go.
Yep.
Next.
David, thanks for everything. One-year-old Golden Doodle has went from a terrible dog to a superstar in the last 2 months. We are now in the rewarding stage, and it is awesome.
2 months? Damn. That's pretty good. Look at that. Turn around in 2 months. Next.
Maria, my soon-to-be one-year-old GSD has been on e-collar the last 6 months at 100. She doesn't respond to anything lower. Is this okay?
No, it's not okay. Something's wrong. So stop what you're doing, please. Something is wrong. Number one, what brand is it? Number two, you probably have bad contact. You probably have bad contact. There's no reason why you should be doing that other than to correct a couple of things. So, I mean, most dogs that we work are below 10. You know, that doesn't mean you don't go higher for distractions, but it's probably bad fit. It's probably bad fit. So make sure it's a good quality dog chart recolor technologies. Sport dog and Garmin are okay, but I have a hard time. Garmin sport dogs run hot, and Garmin I have a hard time with the buttons going them to get up and down. I like the speed dial that a dog chart and a e-collar technology offers, but you shouldn't be that high. So something's going on. Next.
Jerry, I got my remote collar today.
Nice. Start out with place and getting the dog to follow you.
Moot Worm. Tried dog trot on previously e-collar trained dog just for fun. Hasn't been on e-collar in 3 to 4 years, though. Very independent dog. Became super clingy and tried to climb in lap after session. Thoughts on why?
You might have been using the collar too high. Next.
Jody. Hi, I have two dogs, a small pit bull mix and a medium-sized boxer mix. They're really good girls. When they play, they help each other. Sometimes, should I allow this or no? They help on each other sometimes?
Maybe they hop on each other. Nothing that rhymes with biting. So, yeah. It's fine. So, it's fine. As long as they're not biting and fighting, that's fine. And as long as you can tell them to knock it off and they immediately knock it off, that's fine. My dog's rough play outside, but they also will stop it immediately when I tell them to. Next.
Pichu, hi Jeff and Joel. Good evening. I missed you guys.
Hey Pichu, we missed you too. I truly missed the show. That's why I'm doing one tonight. I'm only in town for two nights, and I'm doing a show on both nights. Next. Thank you, Joel, for co-hosting.
No problem. Brandon, got my rat terrier prong collar today. Practiced around the yard and had no pulling, which is a first. Thanks for all the videos and Q&A.
Awesome job.
Alexander, started using bonker to communicate wrong behavior as per your last suggestion. Works awesome. Thank you. Also using prong collar on walks. It's like a wheel for my dog. Thank you. Thank you.
So here's a great example of somebody tuning into a complimentary show, getting advice, applying it, and shit just starts getting real. And I'm not saying this to boost my ego at all. I have plenty of mirrors in my house for that. What I'm saying is, if you're struggling with your dog and you don't have to watch any of my content at all, you don't have to watch any of my videos, but there's so much free content out there by like-minded folks like myself that are free, that work in a relatively quick fashion, that dramatically change your life. And if you're struggling, and I'm not talking about aggression, I'm not talking about high levels of anxiety or even like separation anxiety, high levels of reactivity, that you need a skill set for, you really do. But I would say that 90%+ of what people are struggling with can easily be resolved with somebody's free video out there and some time, and not a lot of time. So we're almost at a point where we can actually say, if you've got a badly behaved dog, then you're just not trying hard enough. But I want to have a disclaimer on that, because I'm not trying to shame or call people lazy. Do you know what I mean? Because that's not my MO at all. But there's almost no reason why, if you have a badly behaved dog in January, you can't do some research, bust your ass for probably 90 days, mm-hmm. and literally in 90 days go, holy shit, I can't believe I've made it this far, like in a good way, like look at how far we've come. And people struggle for years, and I just don't want it anymore. I just don't. So congratulations to you. Kudos to you. Thank you so much for consuming this content, because, man, that's why I do it. And that's why – so I just came off of a 7-day seminar on how to start a dog training business, and a lot of personal growth, social media. We talk a lot about all the online hate and all the online bullying, and I get so much – I get so, so, so much stuff. It's incredible. Everything from being called a pedophile to I'm hanging dogs to I'm like kicking the shit out of dogs to I'm abusing dogs, like to like, I mean, all kinds of stuff that like I can't imagine any of it upsetting me. Like it's all just nonsense. I mean, fuck with my kids, I'll kill you, you know, but other than that, it's like, bring it on, because I mean, you have to be a real asshole. What I tell my students is anybody that goes online and bashes you and talks shit about you, they're just not nice people. So why would you care what they say? Like, why would you care what they say? They're not nice people. Like, it has no, it's no reflection of you as a human being. So, but it doesn't come easy. I mean, that takes, you know, there's a skill set to get to that point in life, but it truly doesn't bother me just because I know it brings me clients. I can't tell you how many times someone has bashed one of my videos publicly. And like, I get all these new followers. They're like, let me see who this asshole is. And like, huh, sort of makes sense. Or they're like, yeah, he's an asshole. It's like, great. I'm glad you figured it out that quick. Like it's like the radio business. When I was in the radio business, it's like, you better have a, like, I remember talking to my producers, like, Jeff, they better have an opinion of you. Mm-hmm. They better either love you or hate you.
Yeah.
And if they don't have one of those, you're not doing your job. Mm-hmm. So, next.
Next. Jerry, can you train a dog without the leash and just use the e-collar?
Yes, but it's harder to do it. It's harder to do it, but yes, you can. Next.
Alexander, for my question today, 4-month Jack Russell Terrier growls at my kids and sometimes wife when they pet her, not me. What should we do with this behavior?
I would need a little bit more info to find out what the situation is. Like if there's any other environmentals, but bottom line is if all things are sort of neutral, the dog is telling that it's not comfortable around the kids and the wife. Okay. I get it. I'm aware of what growling is, but why not? And what's going on? What else is going on in the room? I would need a lot more information. But, you know, if everything was sort of like there's no difference, then it's a relationship issue most likely. And you would correct the dog. You'd correct the dog for it.
Top chat.
Top chat for $9.99. Lauren, just wanted you to know how much I appreciate what you do. I found your content about a month ago, and you are changing the world for me and my two pity girls. Thank you. Lauren, number one, thanks for the $9.99. That's like fucking espresso and dessert, but which is actually what it is. Not for me. I actually didn't eat dessert at all.
Once big surprise.
Yeah, yeah, nothing. She's like, two spoons? I'm like, I don't even do spoon.
No fun in his life anymore. Bananas and salad are like the new thing. You want to get Jeff really excited, put some bananas in a salad. That's all the excitement he gets. Ooh, an extra 100 calories. Woo!
You're taking away from Lauren's comments. You are.
You talked about dessert.
So anyway, so thank you so much. Next.
John, don't twist it on me. I have a 9-month-old German Shepherd.
Lon Junos is a lot of fucking young dog. Who's this?
Kira.
Kira.
She misses me.
There's a lot of young dogs in today's questioning.
Mm-hmm.
Kira, nine.
I have a 9-month-old German Shepherd. Pees in the crate when you go near or open the door to crate. What can I do?
Mm-hmm. Could be nervous, could be fear, could be excitement. What I would do is, a lot of these dogs, what we do is we don't address nervous, fear, excitement, pee directly. We put the dogs in our program, which consists of lots of structure. You know, we don't punish the dog for doing that. Lots of structure. You probably want to keep an excitement level down inside the house, especially. Train the dog up on obedience, and a lot of that stuff just organically goes away. I don't have any direct way to just stop that. It's more of like a universal thing. Next.
Aaron, dog knows how to use the doggy door for 8 months now, but only uses on command and always hesitates.
Good.
We'll go outside after potty and wait until called inside.
Good.
She's prong and e-collar trained. What would Jeff do? I want her to come back in without waiting to be called inside.
Why? You want a dog to just have random access? Most people would love to have that dog. And why is it so hard just to call the dog inside? That's fantastic. So I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do because that's, I would train what your dog is doing. Next. Sorry, I can't. That's mm-hmm. that. I would. That's to me. Well, a dog that actually listens to boundaries and stuff,
yeah.
and is on a permission-based program. That's great.
Stacy, hi Jeff. Love your video so far. Quick question about training deaf dogs: is it better to go with ASL signs or adapt and make our own hand signs for commands?
Up to 1,000% up to you. It's all you. But I would keep it simple. Like you're making it too complicated. Keep it really simple. Next.
Oh, I already read that. Mario, welcome back, guys. I'm fostering and training friend of mine's dog. It's amazing what structure and making him work for his food can do.
Nice. Agreed.
Andrew, I have a 1.5-year-old German Shepherd mix, male, and 2-year-old Pit, female.
Mm-hmm.
They were fine until he was neutered. He attacked my Pit the first day we brought him home after surgery.
They should have been separated, first of all, because of the discomfort that he was most likely in. And also, when you lose your balls... you get angry. Now when you get a little bit of anger issues going on there, it's like you. So, but the dog might have been still, you know, drugged out, still on drugs. I don't know. There's a lot of variables. What I would do now is, I mean, did the de-sexing cause the aggression? I doubt it. The dog was probably in discomfort. It might have still been under the influence of drugs. I mean, who knows? Who knows? Next.
Amber, the Sparkle Fox. I use my dog's kibble as treats. 11 months old Great Dane. He seems to be losing interest in the treats. I started using toys as rewards, but he's also starting to lose interest. What do I do?
I mean, I don't teach increase of food drive, so I'm the wrong guy to ask for that. That's sport dog stuff. Are you overfeeding your dog? Some people say, oh, use higher value treats. But yeah, but the dog will end up fucking getting the shits, you know? So you could. You could, I mean, you can switch to raw. You can do some cooked chicken if you want to. I don't build up the dog's food drive other than only using food to get it to work. Maybe it's getting older. It doesn't need as much food, but it's a freaking great Dane. Goes through probably like 5-6 cups of food a day, at least I would imagine. I won't be that helpful on that one. Next.
Matt, thank you so very much for the detailed answers.
You're welcome.
Shane. At this rate, your next date night is going to be at a steakhouse for sure.
Meaning we're getting a lot of money tonight?
Yeah.
Yeah. Or just over these last 2 weeks. Yes.
Cute kitty. Okay. So I know this dog that has really bad separation anxiety. It will bark if its owner goes 2 feet away from him. He'll bark and not stop. He is a min pin dog.
Correct it with a remote collar or bonker. No bonk. Next.
Mel H. I have a 90-pound, almost 9-month-old Rottweiler. I have the Mini Educator 300. How do I find his working level? I've watched a ton of videos, but I want to make sure I'm doing it correctly. What would you command?
Okay.
300 isn't strong enough. Recommend.
Okay. I have a video on how to watch the working level. So watch that one. You don't need to watch a ton of them. Just watch one. How to get the working levels in dogs. So watch that one again. Make sure you got proper fit. It's on the side. It's turned on. And make sure there's no environmentals, like no sounds, no noises, no nothing going on. Do it inside. Really laser focus on that dog and look for what you need to look for. Next.
Cute kitty. He has a fear towards men. That same min pin that has separation anxiety.
Okay. Same thing. We don't know if he has a fear towards men. That could be something that we just think of. Whether he does or not, he still can't be barking when you move away from him. Next.
Brad, hey, I was wondering about potty training. I just got a 7-week-old German Shepherd. How long does it usually take?
Depends. I'm not a potty training guy, so I would get a book on that or watch a video. All depends on you and your skill set and your structure. Next.
Top chat, David Smith.
David Smith. Man, we're not going to go through all the questions.
No.
Here's for tomorrow. I have to miss doing my own Q&A at the same time. Awesome. Thank you, David. I appreciate it. Next. You want to prepay for?
I would crash his Q&A if I could get on there.
David, you want to prepay for the next year? I want to take a trip.
Yeah. I don't know where we are anymore. Victoria, walking my dogs on prong and they are doing okay. Not perfect yet. I'm dreading the day we meet another person walking dogs on the street. How do I prepare for that? I just know it will be nuts.
Well, Victoria, unless you live on an island somewhere or in the middle of nowhere, you're probably going to do it. What I would do is I'd hunt for dogs. I'd be proactive. Let's see what your skill set's like. Go find dogs. Next.
Kara, my dog is typically in a crate while I'm at work, 6 hours or so. Came home today, her broken out of the kennel. She dragged all my blankets into her kennel. Why would she do this and how can I stop?
Why would she do this? Because she's a dog. All right, that's the simple answer. If anybody gives you a more complicated answer than that, they're just trying to sound smart. Why? Because that's what dogs do. Like, why do dogs eat their poop? Because that's what they do. Why do they lick their balls? Because they can. I mean, how do you make it stop is put carabiners and zip ties on the crate so they can't get out. That's what you do. You make the crate very strong. Next.
Melvin, can a command break another command, and can there be multiple commands for the same thing? Can I mark with yes and good, or do I need to pick one? Thank you.
I would pick, okay, so yes, you can use it. If my dog is in a down and I say place, it will leave the down and go to place. If you say place, which the dog is in a down, so you don't have to necessarily break to get, you know, in between. As far as like yes and good, there's two different words, so you want to be consistent. You want to be consistent with that.
Jamal, welcome back, guys.
Thanks, Jamal. $4.99 top chat. Lauren, started a decaler a week ago for 11-month-old and 3-year-old pit girls. Recommend working with one dog at a time to start or put one in place to help with duration? Both. Yes. If the dog can be in place with duration, do that. If not, crate it up and work with the other one. Next.
Cute kitty. I have a min pin dog and he thinks he's top of the house. He'll pee on anything when he feels he wants. Getting what he wants, like he will stand and pee right where he is, and he does not listen to anything or anyone. He'll freak out, has severe separation anxiety, and will bark and not stop.
Okay, so you've got a shitload of issues that you need to resolve. Number one, he doesn't think he's necessarily like the top dog. I mean, he just decides to piss everywhere. So what I would do is the first thing I would say is like, what's the structure of that house look like? How much freedom does that dog have? Is he on a normal bathroom schedule? Is he structured, you know, structured feeding times, structured water times? Does he have access to walk around that house whenever he wants? Why? Why isn't he on a leash in command? Does he spend enough time in the crate? Not bad dog going in the crate, but it's like, I can't keep my eyes on you. Go in the crate. So you need to, what's happening is most owners are just sitting back hoping for the best. And I'm like, F that, let's be proactive. You know, nothing in life is free sort of, you know, attitude. So you can take it all back in a day. Take it all back in a day. So watch my videos, start consuming my content. Next.
David Smith, Romy and Angela were awesome in the airport on your IG.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, they had a great trip. And then Romy's going on the next trip with me in 2 days. Wait till we see this one. We're leaving for the airport at 4:30 in the morning.
Poor girl.
Too interesting, I know.
Is that another top chat?
Nope.
Okay. Mr. Robert, greetings and congratulations. Please, it is my first bull terrier puppy training that has come to be a pain in the ass. Yeah, any advice? Thanks.
Well, yeah, I mean, even if this was your 10th one, there's still, you know, puppies can be a pain in the ass. So what I would do is this. Start with the basics. Leash on the dog whenever it's out of the crate right now until your dog is under voice control. Massive amounts of structure. Massive amounts of downtime. Everything you make the dog work for, everything from the simplest thing, like you will wait to eat your food, you'll wait to thresholds, you'll wait to go in and out of your crate, being proactive, the obedience commands, stopping the unwanted behaviors, just start consuming my rabbit hole of material. But start out with structure. What's the day going to look like? Structured walk, structured play. Yes, it could still have free time, but no free roaming around the house. That has no value right now. Go down the rabbit hole. All I can say is go down the rabbit hole. Next.
Victor, thanks from Puerto Rico for the answer.
You're welcome.
Camilo Polgarin, I will be calling, guys. Nice job.
Nice.
Melvin, sometimes we say yes and sometimes good boy. Is that bad?
It's not that it's bad. It's just not consistent. You're using two different words for the same thing. And chances are your dog doesn't care. But, I mean, if you want to technically – like if you wanted your dog to lie down, would you say down and then lie down, I guess? I mean, I guess you could, but dogs think in pictures. So it'd be a lot easier that if the dog heard the same word. Next.
Terv, hi Jeff and friends. My dog always runs and skates on hardwood floor when not in place and my boyfriend walks past him. He gets in the way and makes us both trip up or he'll hit his head on something. Help.
Okay. So your dog is not situationally aware about spatial stuff. So there's something called the out command, which means get out of here. We actually train it. It means get out of my way, get out of my way. So your dog is just like, he doesn't respect space. So that's a remote collar protocol where we actually, if the dog gets too close to you, you can actually correct it and it pushes the dog away. Next.
Michelle says during the day, oh, the dog in the kennel that won't sleep.
Oh, see? Okay. Good memory.
Juliana, I'm getting two bull mastiff pups soon, 8 weeks old. What suggestions do you have to get them on the right path to training?
Only get one. Okay, it says you're getting, that means you haven't gotten them yet. Please only get one dog. Only get one dog. Please do not get two puppies. Chances are they're from the same litter as well, which makes it even more difficult. I would never get two dogs at the same age at the same time, or even close. I wouldn't get an 8-week-old dog and a 14-week-old dog. Nope. It's going to be a host of issues for a while, unless you've got a special skill set, and you most likely don't, because not many people do. And then you're also asking how to get them on the right path, which I love. That's why you tuned in. That's why you tuned in. So for that, I love you came to me for help. I don't want to push you away, but it's also an indicator of how it's going to be so difficult for you to do. It's just going to be difficult. Now you might be like, fuck you, Jeff. I'm not going to listen to you. And you come back on this show in a year and you're like, guess what? I didn't listen to you. I got the two pups and I kicked ass with it. That could happen. Which would make you highly unusual, though. The norm is it's the worst decision that anybody ever makes. So, next.
Russ, welcome back. Good to see you both.
Hey, Russ. Love your content, buddy.
Stacy, 1-year-old GSD is being hyper and acting pushy, aggressive with anyone near me. This has started after me recently starting training back up and putting my foot down on bad behavior, yep. But also working good behavior and keeping him directly with me most times.
Yeah, I would also start working on duration, place away from you. And then also we do the out command, which means, hey, dog, get out of here. So the dog needs to learn what no means a little bit better. And then also get the dog to start doing out away from you. Next.
Melissa, what bark collar do you recommend?
Garmin bark limiter, as well as e-collar technologies bark collar. The e-collar technology one we have on our website. Next.
AG donated $1.99. I posted my question below. Thanks for the help.
All right. Thanks, AG. Yeah.
I'm going to read hers because it's right there.
Yep. Sorry that I didn't get the top chat because it's under $4.99. It's got nothing to do with me.
So she says, my Aussie is acting territorial. He's never been that way before. How do I integrate new golden retriever puppy in the home safely? Do I e-collar correct for growling, snapping?
Yes, you do. But advocate for that dog as well. Don't let the puppy get in its face. Next.
JT, hi Jeff. My boyfriend got two male husky puppies that are 10 weeks. He already had three Shiba Inus, a Chihuahua, and a 13-year-old Shepherd.
Jesus Christ.
They scream in the crate if the door is closed. If left open, they do not scream. Should we leave the crate door open at night? They seem better with toys. That's it.
Match.com. Fucking run. Just run and don't look back. Two dogs, 10 weeks old, that don't like to be crated. Okay. Let's assume you're going to keep them, even though I highly suggest, and you've got three Shiba Inus, you've got five other dogs, you have seven dogs. When does the fucking ARC show up? It's like, enough already. Enough. Like, what I would do, though, let's say you're going to keep them. Again, let's say it's like, F you, Jeff. I didn't come onto the show to get lectured. I came onto the show for advice. Stop fucking giving me a hard time. I'm madly in love with this dude. I'm not going to fucking jump on a match. Okay, well, there's always Tinder. Then what you do is this. Close the door. If the dogs, and make sure they're in separate crates, even though I'm highly encouraging you to have one go back to the breeder or wherever else it came from. Okay. And You tell the dogs to knock it off. How do you do that? Hit the top of the crate, bonk the front of the crate, shake the crate, tell it to knock it off. And if you hear, oh my God, the dog will have a negative association with the crate, it already does. So next.
Deanna, it's not play. He has a bite history. He's tense, staring, growling, tail stiff. This is regarding the Rottweiler in the fenced in yard.
You would correct that really firmly. All that staring and all that arousal like that you'd correct that hard. Get rid of it. Next.
C-Dubs Fitness. How do you personally correct a young pup like 8 weeks old for unwanted behavior? I know everyone has different thoughts and would love to hear yours.
Yeah, I would need to know what it was. I need way more information. What's the unwanted behavior? I need to know. Obedience? Nothing. It's like they don't correct it for obedience at all. You know, so I would need to know it. And an eight-week-old puppy, I would need to know specifically what you're trying to stop, and I will tell you exactly what I would do. Next.
Cottonflower, alive on a Tuesday?
Yeah, I was flying overnight. Shout out to JetBlue, another great flight from San Diego to Boston. Got in at 4:30 this morning. I'm here tonight and tomorrow night, and then Thursday morning at 4:30 in the morning, I head out again for a week. So, next.
KDP, I bonked my reactive Roddy as we were getting out of the car at group class last week. I only had to give her one prong correction after we entered, and she was great the whole hour. Thanks.
Yeah, that whole concept of that pre-walk, pre-whatever bonk works great. Congratulations.
Says the instructor had been blaming the prong collar and wanted me to try a different one. No thanks.
Katie, time for a new class. Next.
Shane, what's the link between dog fighting and treadmills?
The link is that you're exercising the dog. That's the link. The dog fighting dog is working up its stamina by being on the treadmill. Fighting dogs are on treadmills. What's even more that they're on is slap mills, a carpet mill or a slap mill. It's a stupid fucking thing. Stupid. It's so stupid. Next.
Joan, do you have a recommendation for a particular e-collar, mini educator, Garmin, etc.? I have a great Dane.
Yep, mini educator. We've got them on our website, but you can also buy them from Amazon if you want to save $20. Next.
Shane, say no, then bonk the government, lol.
You can do that too. Next.
AG, your methods changed our reactive Aussie. I was nervous to correct high on e-collar, but it worked. He's not anxious anymore around strangers, and he's happier. His life is much better, and he's healthier.
Yep. So AG, the cool thing is these aren't my suggestions. I'm just the guy with the big mouth delivering the information, but I'm also the one that also does this. I'm also the one that's outspoken about this stuff. A lot of people like to hide because they don't want to get the hate. But the bottom line is what you just did, that high-level correction for small infraction, which freaks everybody out, it works great. Congratulations. Proud of you, AG. Next.
Doug's on Dog Training Dojo. Hi, Jeff.
Hey, what's up?
How do you stop a five-year-old adopted pug from barking at all and everyone who walks by the house when he's on the porch? No e-collar, per owner's dead set against it.
Okay. So first of all, Doug, welcome. I don't know if I've seen you before, but it's not the age of the dog. It's not that he's adopted, and it's not a pug. Got it? And I just say that because none of those things mean anything to the question. And I want everybody to know that this is general to everybody. Well, all of a sudden, someone's like, I never see you give out beagle advice. I'm all my stuff is beagle advice.
Yeah.
If the owners don't want to use the e-collar, in my world, Doug, they're not clients. So I don't know how you pre-screen clients, but it's like I set the rules, not the client. So what do you do? How about a bark collar? Put a bark collar on the dog. If they're opposed to that, then they're not clients. Like that's the easiest, simplest, most effective, most well-timed, longest-lasting tool that there is. So why not do that? So I'm not going to make stuff up just to make so it fits into their ideology of stuff. What would you do? You'd walk out there, say no. You'd bonk the dog. You know, that's what you do. But tell them to either this is the protocol, this is what I recommend, and if they don't want to take it, they don't take it. That's on them. Next.
Cottonflower.
Oh, shit. We've gone on long enough.
All right.
So we're not going to get all these. We're not going to get all these questions. We're going to get a lot of fucking questions left over.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys. I'm really sorry. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my God. That's a lot.
Guys, sorry.
Well, we got another one tomorrow.
Yeah. Sorry, I couldn't get all the questions, guys. We had a lot of people on this show. There's almost, at one point, there was close to 200 people.
Shane says, don't say sorry. You're a hero.
Sorry. I'm from Canada. Sorry. I'm not from Canada. Thank you so much, guys, for joining tonight. I really, literally loved it. I love the show. Thank you, Joelle, for having another great show. Thank you for taking the time out of your busy night, busy day for coming over. People don't realize that, like, she's, like, you know, doesn't own any part of the company. There's no obligation for her to do any of this stuff other than, like, she wants to help as well. So I really, really appreciate it. Thank you, everybody, for joining. Thank you for asking the questions. Thank you for, if it's your first time on here, yep, it's in your face. But if you want to go to one of my seminars, they're not like this. The humor is like this, but the intensity is not. It's very proactive, very hands-on, very loving and caring. And then obviously my clients actually come to the center. They expect if I work with a client, like if I work with you, which I don't work with a lot of clients anymore, it's like, you're not going to get this guy. It's like, you get quiet Jeff. So you get very quiet Jeff, methodical Jeff, you know, dog trainer Jeff. This is more like, you know, the what would Jeff do, Jeff? Do you see all those fucking coffee mugs that infiltrated the good dog's cabinets? They're all over, man. They're loving them.
Nice move.
Stickers.
Yeah.
Everything.
Everyone gets a box today. I'm like, oh, all the mugs.
Yep. That was great. All right. I love all you guys. Thank you so much.